Alexandra Paul.
I'm Michelle Harris.
I'm Kerri Kasem.
And we are the Animal Angels.
Okay, well, first of all, I have to say, you three are absolutely amazing human beings. You are doing such incredible work, and I commend you so much for what you're doing. How did you guys end up meeting and creating this amazing foundation for saving animals around the world? It's absolutely incredible, and you now are the Animal Angels.
Well, we would just see each other all the time at different animal events, and we became friends, and one day I just said, you know what, we're kind of like working to do things for animals. And I said, we can do a lot more if we work together as a group. So that's really where Animal Angels came from.
Yeah, we're all in the entertainment industry. I'm an actress, and Michelle is a talk show host, and Kerri is a radio DJ. So it just made sense that, you know, together, all three of our voices are even exponentially stronger for animals.
You know, I met Alexandra in the 90s when I gave a speech about actually Newt Gingrich. Do you remember that? And I gave it for my father, and he couldn't make it. So I did that, and she walks up to me, she's like, you did such a great job. Thanks. And so then I would see her at all these animal protests, and we'd do these protests, you know, whatever, if it was a circus or the zoo or whatever it may be, she was always there, and Michelle was, you know, doing her thing, and we kind of got to know each other that way. So we then formed the foundation.
That's incredible. Yeah. So what's a daily life like for the Animal Angels? How do you guys go about working with animals? Do you pick and choose who you want to help out? Is there certain foundations and certain fundraisers that you work closely with?
Well, I kind of say that we're like, I don't know what to call us, the A team, but we get so many requests for help from different groups. So we go where we're needed, and unfortunately there are so many places where animals need help.
Yeah.
So within, you know, we'll get together and say, okay, you know, this week we're going to go out, like we just did something with Delta Rescue. They were trying to bring more attention to their group, which is an ACT in California, and they take in dogs who are abandoned in the mountain and desert areas. So we just went out and did something with them, or all three of us are involved heavily with animal adoption, and we just came together to do the stretcher mutt for best friends.
So tell me, what do you guys have in store for the next year for Animal Angels?
We're going to be helping animals wherever they need help, especially with pet adoptions, which is so important. Because there are, and you know this, Taylor, from your own work, right?
Yeah.
So there are so many animals that need help. So that's where a lot of our focus is, because there's so much need there.
Like Michelle said, whenever they call us, we go and we try and raise awareness, whether it's bringing the media.
We're going to be leafleting about
spay and neuter. Well, even this week, I should say, like, Alexandra just won Vegan of the Year.
Yeah, that is incredible. Congratulations.
And then 2 days before that, we were out with the ASPCA. And, of course, one of the great things that I think we're also thrilled about today is we're doing this wonderful shoot with Bellus. Mm-hmm. But we were able to incorporate dogs who are up for adoption. They're coming from Best Friends.
Yes.
So that is one of the ways that we can help get the message out. It's like, okay, we're doing a magazine shoot. Is it all right if we have these adoptable dogs? And people can then go to pets.overstock.com. And even though these dogs are from Best Friends in Los Angeles, they can find dogs all over the country. Oh. They can find cats all over the country. Something near and dear to my heart, they can find bunnies from all over the country. And even things like chickens and turtles. Because there's so many different types of animals who are up for adoption. So wherever you live, you can go to pets.overstock.com. And as a matter of fact, when we're doing the photo shoot today, they were nice enough to supply some really adorable collars and leashes for the adoptable pets. So not only will we be wearing fashions, but so will the adoptable pets.
Yes.
So it's really fun, and Overstock just kind of did this to help animals. It's not something that they are using to make any kind of money.
Yeah.
They just saw that there was a need, and there's so many animals who need homes. They said there's an overstock of animals, and we need to help fix that.
Oh,
so it's a really
amazing,
great thing that they're doing.
Good for you guys. Well, I want to know, tell me your favorite story of rescuing an animal or helping out somewhere, maybe a protest that you guys did together.
and there was a call to rescue a baby seal. And Alexandra got the call, and she went, literally, we're shooting, and the guy's like, I have to leave right now. There's a seal, very sick, we have to go rescue him. Mm-hmm. And she literally goes, they go and get the baby seal, and they bring him back. And it was the first time I was this, literally this close with this beautiful, I mean, this, I just can't tell you how beautiful it was. Like, it was like looking into a dog's eyes. I don't know if you've ever been that close. They look like the most like beautiful human dogs. Yeah, they were human, these big eyes. So that was amazing for me.
But they have a bite. Don't go up to a
very, very, very strong bite. Oh, I didn't know this, how the pressure is, I mean, what was it, like 10 times worse than if you got
bit by a pit bull.
Oh yeah. My gosh. Yeah. And so they lure you in with those eyes, just to be careful though.
So if you're at the beach, just don't go up to one call and get someone who knows how to do wildlife rescue and sea mammal rescue to come out and help you. But I mean, all of us have rescued so many different kinds of animals. I've done everything from ducks, which are really fun and hard to catch because they can fly, to foxes. I've had raccoons who just hugged me around the neck, like baby raccoons who couldn't be released, who are in sanctuaries. So cute. Now, I have a funny story that I was telling before about Kerri. We were helping out at Gentle Barn for the day, which takes farm animals and rescues them. Mm-hmm. So we were just doing some cleaning, and I thought it'd be funny to prank Kerri, because Kerri will tend to be like, Alexandra and I will be doing our thing, and Kerri is like this.
Sorry.
And so she'll be off
she'll
talking.
She'll be off talking. And
she's a social butterfly of the three of us. And so anyhow, so I said to Alexandra, I said, I'm going to get Kerri with this. And yes, I did bring fake poop.
Yes.
And I said, and we're standing there, and I said, oh my God, I stepped in something. And then I said, Kerri, come over. And she came over and I grabbed it and went,
what's going on?
But I think one of the funniest things that happened to us was we were just having an angels meeting.
Oh, like about, I know this.
Yeah,
one.
You know this.
You have angels meetings. Yeah. This is so cute.
Yeah, we have angels meetings. Like, okay, like we have. I mean, we do have an abundance of people who need our help.
Yeah.
So it's just trying, like, okay, what are we doing this week? Can we all get together and working our schedules and all that kind of thing? So
yeah, how do you decide like who you're gonna go help and who you have to turn down?
Well, we actually, you know, for the three of us, we really think a lot on the same. We're very much individuals, but we do have a lot. We're just in sync, and so we usually we agree.
The same thing. Yeah.
It's all good. It's just there's only so much.
So much you can do.
But sometimes it's immediacy. Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes we'll just get a call. Like, I was doing an area by the 5 freeway where there was a bunny dump. Mm-hmm. They had dumped a few bunnies, domestic bunnies, and not cottontails. And, you know, 2 turned into 50. But at the same time, you're trying to get these bunnies, you have the danger of the freeway, and you have heavy brush, broken glass, and they're not easy to catch. So it took us like every weekend for summer, but that was an immediate need situation to get these animals out of harm's way. So sometimes there's something, it's like, okay, can we go now? Or one time, I believe it or not, I was at a fitting in downtown LA, and I'm calling both of these two, like 911. I'm like, hey, I just left this fitting. I stop in front of the Staples Center because someone had hit a pigeon.
Oh, man.
And I'm like, you guys, I don't have any resources with me. I picked up the pigeon, put it in my car. I'm like, you have to tell me where to go. Where's the closest place where I can take an injured pigeon? So, like, we all coordinate like that. If something happens, that's immediate.
You guys really are angels.
Oh,
it's so great.
That's so nice.
But if people want to help out and really help you guys and spread the word about, you know, neutering and helping animals, What do you suggest? What advice do you give out to the public?
I think the most important thing is education. I don't think a lot of people don't realize that don't buy an animal. Animals are not to be bought. Yes. They are creatures in their own right. Mm-hmm. We don't own them. We take care of them. We're their guardians. We're not their owners.
Right.
And so it's really important that people do not support buying any animal at all. And then spaying and neutering is really important because...
And we need harsher laws about that because what, you know, you can say, oh, you should spay and neuter. Oh, here's a law. You can only have like 3 to 5 animals. I feel like there's a lot going on that can be stopped so all these animals don't have to die in shelters. Yeah. So many hundreds, I mean millions of animals that die every year because
somebody didn't spay or neuter.
Just so, an irresponsibility.
Absolutely. And I think for me, getting into politics lately, in this last year, I think there should be, and you know, we've talked about this, some harsher legislation that should be definitely...
It's not.
I don't want to say like, and I don't feel like people should be punished for having animals. So it's hard for me to say.
Incentivizing.
They shouldn't be punished, and I don't want it to sound like that. But I really believe that there should be stricter laws so this doesn't happen.
In Los Angeles, there are stricter laws, but it's really making spaying and neutering available to everyone at a low cost, which a city does do. But guess what? We need, and that's one of the things we need to do as the Animal Angels, to get the word out to people like, hey, the city of Los Angeles will give you a voucher so that you can go and get your animal spayed or neutered. Or, you know, they also have mobile spay-neuter vans that are completely free. So they can go into low-income areas where we have a lot of these problems. And then, of course, you know, there's other things that go on, like dog fighting and other issues, too, that we need to raise the education.
Cat declawing, tail docking, ear cutting, all those things are
the plastic surgery. Yeah, for animals is disgusting.
It's fine for humans, but animals.
For me, it's fine
because you can make the decision. Make the decision.
That's right.
It's just absolutely terrible. Well, if people want to follow what you guys are doing in your journey, where can they follow you guys?
Facebook. Yeah, Animal Angels TV.
Okay, perfect. Thank you guys so much for coming. You guys are incredible, and I can't wait to help you guys out on any new missions you have coming out.